Hey beautiful people of Ghana, I'm back again with another video. I hope that you all are doing amazing. Thank you for tuning in again to see another one on my channel. And of course, to those of you that are new here, hi, my name is Lillian, and today we are taking a look at STEM education in Ghana. Fine, you guys have been on this, like, I've got so many comments requesting I take a look at STEM in Ghana. But the reason is I delayed because I didn't understand what it means. This is new to me, and I didn't want to come here just because, you know, I can see video or two just talk about it. So I decided to take some time to do my research, get to understand it, digest it, get to make sure that it is for what I believe in, for what I stand for, which is education for all. And I wanted to understand if it is for some selected families or it is for the general public. So I had to take some time off to get to know more before I would do a video on it. So finally it is here. First, what we are going to do is get to understand what STEM education is, followed by us going to tour some of the campuses that I can find, and after that take a look at the impact of STEM education in the lives of these students that are doing it. So, and then after that we are going to meet the brain behind this whole idea in person of the Minister of Education in Ghana. And after that I have a video of Americans that are seeking for collaboration with the Ghanaian Education Authority and all that. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. When something is well done, a lot of people would be interested in it. And I wanted to understand so many things before I get myself into this video. Now that I have understood, let's get you to understanding. I will be back. Let's go.
STEM. It's one of the most talked about topics in education. But what exactly is STEM? STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, but it's more than that. STEM has grown to represent a unique approach to teaching and learning, one that centers around individual students' learning styles and interests. This means STEM education has something to offer every student. Unlike traditional education experiences in which subject areas are concentrated on separately, STEM education emphasizes technology and integrates subjects in ways that connect disciplines and relate them to each other. So why is STEM getting so much attention? STEM moves beyond simple test performance and focuses on developing higher level thinking skills by connecting classroom learning to the real world. STEM emphasizes collaboration, communication, research, problem solving, critical thinking, and creativity, skills that students need to be successful in today's world, regardless of specific interests or career goals. STEM is a direct response to the realization that our future will be built on our capacity for innovation, invention, and creative problem solving.
Okay, now that you understand, let's go and tour some of the campuses, meet the students, get to know so many things that I didn't know too, but I have known, and I want you to know in case you do not know. So let's go tour some of the campuses and I will be back. Let's go.
Yeah. is state-of-the-art facility built by the President of the Republic of Ghana, Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, through the Sector Minister, Honorable Dr. Yao Osei Edochim.
I think I made a right choice coming to Abomasi, because everything I've learned and what I'm learning is going to help me a lot. I would have missed this opportunity if I had gone to any other school, because what I'm learning here, I'm not sure if I went to any other school, I would have gotten what I'm getting now.
All right.
And I'm really happy that I made the right choice.
First of all, to build a very good culture here, a culture where students should not even be taught before they do what is right, a culture of what learning on their own, a culture where they have the ability to ask relevant questions, a culture where they are innovative, creative, and can do things on their own.
In other schools, from what I know, they've been doing theory, but here we do a lot of practicals, so I'm getting more used to that.
So the school here is practical oriented?
Yes, please.
Oh, okay.
Actually study for life and not because of what we are in school.
This school has been so nice and good. It's very different from other schools since we have ultra modern facilities in here and a very neat environment.
It's been a very great experience, especially the teacher having time to explain everything, the facilities for practicals. It has been a very great experience over here.
We are grateful for this institution, and then we are also happy to be here.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Minister for Education, for providing this amazing facility for us. We are grateful.
ICT Lab 2. I'm so excited that I can't just wait to be there.
I'm so excited that the government has given us a STEM school that contains physics, chemistry and biology labs. I want to become a doctor.
I'm a person living with disability. I'm overwhelmed and really fascinated by this edifice. I will describe this facility as all in all, because it tends to encompass all that it takes to make learning quite good. Most especially, I can see this vision has persons with disability and all other ordinary students in mind. It's going to help us not to eliminate persons with disability behind or leave them behind. So my prayers is that we encourage all persons with disability within the municipal to take their learning very serious.
This year are doing great, they are doing marvelous. As you see, one of the students holding a certain car, he has been able with his friends built. In fact,
this is electronic.
He manufactured a car.
It's electronic.
It's very awesome. We have the teacher who happens to be the instructor also within their mess, and I will let them put the car on the floor for them to start, for us to see how it's going to move. And so that is the key.
Okay.
Please, people of my country.
Electronic
car. That is what I'm trying to tell.
Academy. So that is the key.
So that is the key. This is
the slot.
So we have only two heels.
Okay.
That makes the movement for now. We are looking up to look at the four heels, also be able to move so that it can make turns and then other. But we have always been saying that the key, this is the key that will help the car to move. So if you have a car, you need a key before the car moves. Other than that, the car will be aesthetic. So that is what we have over here. And then the students who brought up the idea, and then for us to also help him to improve on the idea that he brought. And then we also have Benedict, who also brought some form of ideas. Yet we are still on our way, we're producing more.
Yeah.
So just be looking up to us.
Yeah.
STEM Academy, STEM Academy. STEM Academy.
Yeah.
We are coming out with so many events.
Wow. God bless you for your
blessing. Bless
Spark the letters, so, go.
Engineering and mathematics. So it has aspects of physics, chemistry, biology. That is basically what STEM. And it's also mixed with mathematical studies and also engineering. That's basically what STEM education. And the country very well, because if we have more students entering into the field of the science, technology, engineering and mathematics, then we know that our industries are going to perform. And if our industries are going to perform, then we'll be on the same level with the high level countries. Then we can transform into an A level country, can transform into a first world country. So it will really transform this world. It will be a biomedical engineer, which will also combine aspects of biology with physics and chemistry, as well as engineering and technology.
I got my motivation from my headmaster, who talked to me about the school, saying so far as I want to do science and study science, I should come to this school because they focus basically on the practicals, which also enables students to understand whatever they are taught very well. That's what motivated me to come to this school. This school focuses on practicals. Its focus is normally on the practicals. So that's what differentiates this school from other schools. Studies are very, very equipped, and like, I don't know.
It's good, and the theory aspect is no more than the practical aspect based on the other senior schools. Because the other senior schools, there are more of theory, but here, practical theory, so that it makes teaching and learning easier and faster. Yeah. I want to be a computer engineer in the future. Yeah. So you're the Obopi. Or you're the Obopi.
Let's go on. How's your experience?
Okay, so being in STEM, I feel happy.
I feel like everything here is practical based. We don't do most of the theory. We do most of the theories, but not like more like how other schools do it. So yeah, that's how I feel. Okay, so for me, I want to become a medical doctor. Yes, please. We learn most of the courses like biology, physics, chemistry, elective maths, and all those things. So for me to become a medical doctor, my focus would be on the biology, the physics, the chemistry, and my science courses. Yes. Please, I'm Ajiman Maya Asumenua, a student of Ompad STEM SHS Abomosu.
Ghana now has some of the best STEM schools in the world. And these are some students from one of Ghana's first girls STEM schools.
I feel very blessed. I feel very privileged being in this school because this school has a lot of equipment. Everything about this school is just modern, just superb. I don't even feel like going to the house anyways. I always want to be in this school to be able to like learn. Like everything here is just good. Just don't feel like going home. In my alma mater, which is University Junior High School, even though it was a big school, we're not having such kind of facilities or equipment. But being in this school, it makes everything easier. For my school, if you're able to search for anything that is virtual or like anything that is virtual, meaning the ICT, the teacher has to use the phone, go around with it. But here, just can sit at the back and just view everything that is being shown from there. I'm very excited.
Oh my God.
Just excited to be in such a school. It's mind-blowing.
I'm lost of words. It's very amazing because whenever a teacher stands in front of you to teach, you understand it, even though the teacher wants to research something or do something, he just stand here and he will just be pressing.
Everything is there. No stress,
nothing. The teacher teaches us so that we will be able to understand everything.
Wow.
In fact, the school is amazing. We are all happy being here, and we thank the Honorable Minister for building such a school for us. We always want to come to the lab to learn because it's very great when we are learning here because we find everything easy because of the avocado board.
Wow.
And the man behind these STEM schools and the STEM education in the country is this man called Dr. Yao Osei Educhum, who is the current Ghana's Education Minister.
You know that when it comes to the subject of investing in the youth of this country so that they have a better chance of succeeding in the future is something that is very dear to our hearts.
At this point, I want to believe you're subscribed to my channel. I mean, why not? Anyways, feel free to subscribe if you wish to, okay? And so let's go back and take a look at the impact of this pattern of education, and I will be back. Let's go.
Medication in Ghana?
Well, it's a lot. I'm sure you listened to what I said. Let me just repeat for the camera. We started in 2011. The foundation was set up by a good friend of mine. Through these 11 years, we have seen probably the biggest impact is that the kids participating in the RISE program have seen improvement in their raw subjects like math, physics, chemistry, biology, and general problem-solving skills. This is the biggest impact, I would say. But if I were to extend it, that same result has translated into doing well in national competitions and even international competitions. Since 2012, we started in 2011, but from 2012, we have participated in international competitions. We've been to Malaysia, we've been to Indonesia, we've been to Russia, we've been to Denmark, we've been to the United States many times, we've been to Costa Rica, and even in India, and they have actually performed. So if you ask me about impact on the kids, it's huge. The other extension, which maybe might be your follow-up question, is many of our kids have had the opportunity to gain scholarship into world-reputed universities in the United States and Israel. We have partnership with a number of universities around the world, and they actually contact us from time to time, actually year after year, to see what students they can recruit into their university. So that's how much the impact has been.
That's amazing. I'd say the Yamransa model is currently focused on junior high school and primary school education, and you're focused more on grooming the senior high school students and more to the international or university level?
The senior high school was the way we started, but now we have expanded southwards and northwards, and by that I mean we've stepped back into junior high, even gone into upper primary and university. So we are literally covering the entire spectrum of education before the job market.
Yeah. How would you say a partnership between you and the Yamransa model is going to help in improving STEM education in the country?
Absolutely. You know, a friend of mine had mentioned the Yamransa model to me, but today is the first time I'm getting a much more complete picture. I think the partnership can come in by way of the Yamransa model, or those managing the centers, knowing the opportunities nationally in terms of competition, as well as international competitions. And even those who will be crossing from senior high to university, that our organization has network that can aid them get all of these opportunities come their way. So I think we have to talk some more. When they get to, when I say we, I'm talking about the managers of the Yamransa model. They have to know what programs we have on an annual basis that translate into national competitions, that translates into international competitions, as well as what we call the international friendlies, as well as university opportunities.
All right, thank you for still watching. Now let's go take a look at the brain behind this whole idea in Ghana regarding the education system in Ghana. Let's go meet the Honorable Minister of Education, and I will be back. Let's go.
I won't leave what I'm doing in America to come to Ghana and play around. We're doing some serious work there in Los Angeles. President came there, saw me, and said, come to Ghana and help me change the education system. Left my schools with over 200 workers there to come. And I'm coming here to play around. I'm coming here to mess up the education system. If I can improve American education system, I will help uplift my nation's education system any single day.
This man is called Dr. Yao Osei Edutu. He's a Ghanaian politician and a member of the 7th Parliament of the Republic of Ghana, representing the Bosumapien constituency in the Ashanti region. And on the 5th of March 2021, he was appointed by President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo as the Minister of Education. He is from Jache in the Ashanti region of Ghana. Dr. Osei Edutu obtained a bachelor degree in Land Economy, Business Administration with a major in Real Estate from the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, Ghana. He holds a master's degree in education management from the University of Laveen, California. And also, he holds a PhD in education policy, planning, and administration from the University of Southern California. He is the founder of the New Designs Charter School in Los Angeles, California. But before that, he worked as a mathematics and information technology teacher at the Manual Art High School in Los Angeles, California, for 10 years. During his period, he founded the International Studies Academy, which served as a small learning community for students to rise academically and socially. He also served as a lead mathematics teacher at the University of California and Manual Art Neighborhood Academic Initiative. He was part of the task force established by the National Research Center for Career and Technical Education to develop a nation model for career and technical education in high schools and colleges in the United States.
Good afternoon to every one of you. So grateful to be here. To Euro Africa Group, the chair is here, and members, the executive. I'm very grateful that I was invited out of all the ministers of education in Africa. I get the opportunity to address you, and I'm excited to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, and esteemed panelists who are going to be joining us, I come to you from the Republic of Ghana. After living in the United States of America for 26 years, don't ask me how I didn't lose my accent. I just didn't want to lose it. I wanted to sound African. I taught in America, high school, as a mathematics and computer science teacher. Then the United States of America began a process of ensuring that disadvantaged youth got the opportunity of quality education in their urban areas. So they brought up the concept of charter schools. These are public-private partnership institutions started by nonprofit organizations, and the tuition is paid for by government. That's yours. Thank you. So you go into those schools in the urban areas of America, and they are offering you a better opportunity than your neighborhood public school, and parents didn't have to pay for anything. So after teaching for about 9 years, I just decided that if I could also be one of those who innovate in the education space in urban centers, something that would be very rewarding to me. I submitted a grant to the federal government and I received $500,000 to begin the adventure of developing my first publicly funded charter school in the city of Los Angeles. It was a great adventure for an immigrant from Ghana. Decided that I would make a difference and that I would build schools that were better than the American public schools. A great challenge. But I began it. I went through public hearings, City Hall of Los Angeles, live on TV. People were watching me, looking at me and saying, where is that guy from? I was challenging the status quo that my schools be better than the public schools in the United States of America. I changed the graduation requirement for my school. I required that every student took a course in engineering in high school and that they got immersed in STEM. Because these were children coming from communities where they have never met an engineer. And I wanted them to have the opportunity in high school to meet one. So I began my school from junior high all the way from high school, changed the graduation requirement, required of them to come to schools on Saturdays, changed the status quo in such a way that at the end of their high school, I'll be able to send them to Harvard and Yale, to Stanford, and to every university in the country, and the magic worked. Students began to come to me, parents line up in front of my school, and they always told me, you cannot be a teacher without a first. So we changed the teacher preparation to 4-year Bachelor's of Education program for you to step into a classroom and to teach.
How did you spend the new year?
Oh, new year, I was with widows in Bosomtree, about 250 of them, dancing with them, sharing food,
and
giving them piece of cloth and sharing some gifts so that they can spend a good new year. I've done that consistently the last 7 years. And
it's amazing.
Yeah, that is it. Do they have to talk about it this long for people to understand? Trust me, I will never do anything I don't understand, even if it's to save a life. I won't. I would like to have an idea of something before I will get myself into it, because, I mean, I would like to be responsible for whatever comes after doing that thing without having to blame others for it. That is why. So I like the fact that there was campaign going on, trying to get the minds of people, to get them to understand what this means and what they stand to benefit. But the fun part for me in all of this is the fact that it is for nothing. It is for a regular Ghanaian, regardless of your family background. You don't have to be from some rich family, or you don't have to know anybody to be selected for this. This is for everyone based on merits. They have their requirements. In case you want to know, check the internet for more or visit their website for more. Get to know what qualifies your child for this. And so with all of that being said, let's take a look at this. So let me play a video of this American education investor in Ghana. I mean, I'll call them investors because, yeah, it's not just one person. I mean, coming to seek collaboration with the Ghanaian Education Authority to be part of, you know, just to also contribute and all that. So let's play that and I'll be back. Let's go.
be? Because that's always a concern. The environment, the infrastructure, how different is it going to be from the one that you have in Kansas, in the United States?
Well, you know, in terms of the education and the academic curriculum, it's going to be as much as it can be the same as it is in Kansas City. But the context in Ghana, I was explaining to some parents recently and some teachers, last week you had Constitution Day. Mm-hmm. We don't have Constitution Day similar to that in the U.S., but we have Thanksgiving and Halloween. So we put it into context and we teach the children accordingly. But in terms of the concepts, in terms of the curriculum which will allow these children to start in the three-year-old program and graduate at 18, they will graduate with a high school diploma that will be recognized
anywhere in the world. So this is a high
school? This is a preschool. So actually it
preschool.
Starts...
Oh, preschool. So pre-university, you mean?
No, three-year-olds.
Oh, three-year-olds.
So babies.
It's called K-12. K is kindergarten, all the way to 12th grade.
Which is end of primary.
And from there, and secondary school.
Okay.
You can go to universities. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Kansas in Ghana is preschool years. Until 18.
Correct.
Okay. All right. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so that's where the question becomes more important. The curricula for a seven-year-old American will by and large be very different from seven-year-old Ghanaian. Are you going to teach him 16 regions in Ghana, 52 states in America, federal system in America, unitary system in Ghana? Ghana has had a history of military interventions. America has 200 years of democracy. Are you going to put all that in the 8-year-old's head, or how are you going to do it?
Well, great question. And the answer simply is we take things and we put them into context. We define it in Ghana based upon the very best aspects of the Ghanaian education system and the curriculum that they want to follow. But again, it's the concepts that we are focusing on, not necessarily the content. The content's going to change no matter what country we're working with. We have schools in China. We have partnership programs in Australia and in Costa Rica. But again, the concepts of what we do is instrumental to the growth and development of any school.
And now, the more I get to, you know, at the very beginning, I didn't understand why I love Ghana this much, a country that I'm not from originally. I mean, why? Is it just the peacefulness? Or is it just the peaceful nature of Ghanaians? Because I am an introvert, and that means that I can excel anywhere, do you understand? Because you hardly see me out there, and that makes it easy for me to live almost anywhere. But I didn't understand why I love this country so much at first sight. I did not struggle. So now I'm getting to know, you know, when, like, I keep saying that Ghana is like that parent that gives her all to her children, denying themselves of the material things of pleasure to just put in all their resources into the future of their children. Ghana reminds me of such a family. And I grew up in a village. I know people that were considered to be poor back then, families that were being looked down on. I see how they make the most sacrifice to get the best for their children. I mean, back then, for a man to prove his worth, for a man to prove that he is wealthy, a man is supposed to have like two wives or more. And then at the end of the day, these people that I know, and then you have other families who are being looked down on because the man is with one wife and they just do everything together. They have a few number of kids and their kids gets the best of education. You see these people go to farm from morning till morning, you know, from morning till evening. And at the end of the day, they put in all their farm produce, whatever they make from the farm, sell it and give this money to their kids to go pay school fees and study well. And then right now they are ruling. All right. They are ruling. Things are happening right in front of me, and I love that transformation, and Ghana reminds me of that, and that is why I love doing these videos, and I hope that you enjoyed this one and that I will see you in my next one. Ciao!